some certain gains. They played games in this region in the past, they're playing them now, and they'll be playing them in the future. The record number 68443, dated November 7, 1914, in the British Foreign Affairs Archives, reads that an Armenian Ottoman general, Bogos Pasha, is ready for independence war under the command of Russia. Another document, dated September 7, 1915, under record number 126836, is a report conveyed to the British Foreign and Commonwealth Office. The report informs on the activities of an Armenian captain, Tarkom. The report is an account of how Armenians plan both the massacres to be committed against the Turks and the independence fight against the Ottomans in detail. Apart from Anatolia, thousands of ethnic Turks and Azerbaijanis were killed by means of torture in Nakhchivan, Ahiska, and Ahirkelek, Azerbaijan. The reason was the dream of a greater Armenia. An expansionist policy from Anatolia to Caucasia was pursued.
The Armenians published a book in 1907 in Yerevan, today's Armenian capital. In this book, 1,301 cities are mentioned to have existed in the region. Armenian authors of the book say that 959 out of 1,301 cities were inhabited by Azeris and 342 by Armenians. Now I ask, where are those 959 cities? They were not only physically destroyed, even their names were obliterated, deleted from maps. Neither the city itself nor the name exists.
Letters of British Foreign Secretary Sir Edward Grey in the public records dated March 6, 1915, and record number 30439, reveal that Armenians were both under the command of Russians and in cooperation with the French. Their aim was the partition of the Ottoman Empire.
When the Armenian uprising started, the same conditions worked the same way. Only the Armenians killed were registered, and a larger number of Muslims who lost their lives were forgotten. Therefore, Armenian losses are told in exaggerated numbers, in most cases, in all historical accounts, and there is very little mention of Muslim losses.
Continuous uprisings and the support by Armenians of the Russian invasion in the east forced the Ottoman administration to take important decisions. It was decided to relocate the people living in the places which came under Russian invasion to safe regions. The administration regulated this through a provisional law. This law is known as the Relocation Law. It comprises four articles, and the first article stipulates to return force and destroy in case of opposition to state forces and disruption of established public order and armed assault or resistance. The second article stipulates that villages and towns whose spying activities and treason against armed forces have been proven can be transferred and relocated to other places. The third article was about the temporary nature of the law, and the fourth article specified the government office responsible for the execution of the law. The text does not implicitly or explicitly mention any ethnic group or community.
Harp içinde bilfiil düşman devlete yardım etmekte.
You cannot criticize the relocation in wartime of those who are the closest to the front from a community that is actively helping the enemy. Likewise, the same policy was implemented during World War I for the Germans in Britain. During World War II, the French descendant inhabitants of Alsace-Lorraine were relocated. Americans gathered the Japanese Americans in camps. The Ottomans did not gather people in camps. They only relocated them in the vicinity of Syria and Iraq, to the south of the region where war was going on with the Russians.
Güneyde Suriye ve Irak içindeki bölgelere nakletti.
Following the relocation law of 1915, Armenian convoys from Erzurum, Bitlis, where a war was going on, and from Sivas, the region of rebellions, started to move. They first came together at temporary gathering points. The Ottoman state promulgated an edict ordering that the elderly, women and children were to be carried by ox carts, carriages, or on horse or other saddle beasts.
Եվ 16 թվին էլ Անդրանիկը, որ Ղարսը պահանջում էին արդեն հանձնել Անդրանիկին.
In 1916, Armenian general Andranik had disbanded his army and returned to Kars.
Հայրս այլևս անելիք չունեին Ղարսում.
When nothing was left to do in Kars, my father and uncle immigrated. They travelled on a way full of torment for days, sometimes on foot and sometimes on carriages. They arrived at Leninagan after a very long journey, but they couldn't stay. There was a cholera epidemic. They went to Tbilisi, but they weren't allowed to go to Tbilisi lest they spread cholera.
Food was distributed, shelter was provided, and field hospitals, which were established by the soldiers, served on the way. Measures were taken for security. The Ottoman state was allocating allowances for those moving, despite the dire financial situation of the state. The state orders were that those who were subject to the relocation law would be provided with housing immediately at their destinations. In addition, if necessary, those people would also be provided with food from the ration of the Ottoman soldiers at war. They would be served hot meals and meat.
Bugos Nubar Pasha, ki Ermeni delegasyonu başkanı.
After the incidents, Armenian delegation president Bogos Nubar Pasha gave an account of the numbers of Armenians and places that they were sent to or immigrated to. According to the numbers he presented, 250,000 went to Russia, 80,000 to Iran. The remaining 390,000 went to Syria and the Aleppo region. The number of those transferred was reported as 600,000 to 700,000 to the French Foreign Ministry. The figure 600,000 to 700,000 they presented originates from this report. Today, it is alleged that 1.5 million were killed.
Ve öldürüldü denilen bugün rakam 1.5 milyon.
Was soll das Ganze? Daraufhin.
Now, what does all that mean? It means it was not a death order. It was an immigration order. And it was not outside the country, but to Syria and Iraq, then the territory of the Ottoman Empire.
Sehr viele Menschen umgekommen sind.
Yes, it is true that a lot of people died in that period. The Armenian Prime Minister, Bogos Nubar, mentioned a 300,000 death toll for the Turks. I have this document in my possession. It has been a long time since we learned that the Muslims had more losses thanks to the demographic studies of Professor Justin McCarthy.
Ein Vielfaches an Verlusten hatte.
Benim anam, babam, Adanalıdırlar, Dörtyollu'dur.
My parents are from Adana, from Dörtyol in Adana. They immigrated to Damascus. From Damascus we went to Beirut. We lived for 5 or 6 years in Beirut. We came to Yerevan in 1946.
The photograph showing the Armenian committee member Mardo, Tigris from Diyarbakir, and their friends posing in front of the Turkish villager they had killed. This actually is the picture of truth. The reasons for the enactment of the relocation law were this kind of Armenian terror and massacres. Those who allege genocide were actually committing genocide themselves. They drove the people out of their homes and forced